the science behind sourdough. Now, it's not the most sexy explanation. It's science, yeah? But I try to do my best to make it as attractive possible for you. It might be a bit boring at some times, but for us sourdough nerds, that doesn't matter. When it comes to making sourdough, we blend flour and water. The flour is full of microorganisms. For us, the most important ones when making sourdough is that we have yeasts and we have the lactic acid bacteria. Now, what is their function in the sourdough? First of all, the yeast will turn the sugars that are present in the starch into CO2 and ethanol. So the yeast will be responsible for the fermentation power of our sourdough. On the other hand, we have the lactic acid bacteria. And don't be scared. But within the family of the lactic acid bacteria, there is two species, two main families. So one are the homofermentative lactic acid bacteria, the other ones are the heterofermentative lactic acid bacteria. The homofermentative lactic acid bacteria, they like temperatures of 35 degrees. The heterofermentative lactic acid bacteria, they prefer temperatures of 20 degrees centigrade. Now, what is the function? The lactic acid bacteria, as you can see, they can only produce lactic acids. Where the heterofermentative, they can produce lactic acid, acetic acid, and sometimes they even produce CO2. Now, how does that convert into a graph? Here we have the axis with the pH, which goes from 0 to 14. Everything that is above 7 and between 14 is alkaline or is base. Everything that is below 7 is acid or sour. For us, of course, when you blend water and flour, the pH will start to lower below 7. And we know that when you lower the pH, at a certain moment your sourdough will be stabilized around 3.5, 3.7 of pH. Most important thing to know is that we need to go below 4.2 pH. From the moment you are below the 4.2 pH, you know that your sourdough is pathogen free, because Mother Nature has decided that everything that is below 4.2, the pathogens are killed. That's the beauty about fermentation. A last thing you have to know about what's happening here is that by lowering the pH, the cause of lowering the pH is the creation of those organic acids, being the lactic acid and the acetic acid that is produced by the lactic acid bacteria. So slowly and little by little, these organic acids are increasing constantly. And that's why probably you've noticed when you do not use your starter for a long time and you take it from the fridge, that the flavor is a bit too tangy, too acid. Well, that's because slowly the total amount of organic acid is increasing. To get rid of those organic acids, you can give your sourdough starter a bath, but that I have another video for that. To slowly conclude, what you need to remember is that pH is a scale from 0 to 14 with acid and alkaline or basic. The TTA is the total amount of organic acids, and that is measured in a different way. It's measured by titration, so a pH meter will have nothing to do with it. And you have to know that these organic acids is the combination of lactic acid and acetic acid. Now, the last thing I will show you, and if you memorize that, you pretty much understand everything that is going on in your sourdough. is that if you have a liquid or a stiff starter and you keep it at 20 or 35 degrees, you will influence the flavor of your sourdough. A liquid sourdough at warm temperatures will give you a lot of lactic acid. That sourdough will be like more yogurty, it will be creamy, milky, with a lot of dairy notes. Whereas if you have a stiff starter and you keep it at cooler temperatures to 20-25 degrees, you favorize the heterofermentative fermentation, and there you have a lot of acetic acids. And that's what's causing that tang in your sourdough, that bit of vinegar type of sourdough. So sourdough is understanding the importance of the viscosity, if you have a liquid or a stiff starter, the temperatures at which you let it mature, between 20 and 25 or 30 and 35. That will influence the flavor of your sourdough and its fermentation power.